In this quick tutorial of SWOOD CAM, we will overview a range of its functionalities from the tool, aggregate and machining libraries, as well as program settings, components positions, manual milling operations, copying programs and much more. Activating the SWOOD CAM add-in will enable an extra tab within your task pane. This will include three libraries of tools, aggregates and machinings. If we delve into greater detail of the tooling library via a right click and edit, this will launch a separate window in which we can create new sublibraries, insert new tools, or edit existing ones. Each tool contains critical information such as reference, head number, tool number, a corrector value if applicable, rotation either clockwise or counter, spindle speed, feed rate in the XY axis, as well as feed rate down in the Z. The type of tool itself can be specified from an extensive list of options, from finishing cutters, roughing, engraving, chamfers, or any other bespoke profile cutter. Once selected, this will change the parameters to fill out, such as tool length, cutter length, diameter, and so on. If we were to edit the aggregate library, we can have a quick look over some training examples of drilling blocks and saw heads. Each aggregate contains its own 3D viewport, which visually highlights spindle's positioning, where the tool can then be defined after via similar options from the tooling library. The machinings library lists the automatic tooling operations which can be applied easily via a drag and drop process. If we were to edit this menu, then we can discover which tool will be used in each operation, as well as further optimization rules. Once the libraries are set up, we can now move on to programming a panel. After opening the file, we will move through the icons in the SWOOD CAM tab from left to right, starting by defining the program settings, components positioning, tools management, then any of the desired operations after that. The program settings needs to define a routing program by selecting a machine type, which will therefore dictate the language the post-processor will encode the program into. Components positioning is used to prescribe the 0-0 point of the panel. This can be pulled through from SWOOD design or changed to be manually editable. A vertex is therefore selected for the OPO, and then filling out an edge in X, Y, or Z can drive that axis direction. Furthermore, we can add in a stock extension value to the length, width, or thickness to oversize the board itself, as well as adding additional incline planes needed for more complex 4 and 5 axis operations, but these will not be applicable for this model. For more of a manual workflow approach, we will start off by dragging in any desired tooling for this panel. A 16 diameter roughing cutter has been added with the sole intention of contouring the outside profile of the panel. A quick technique for initiating this operation is by selecting an outer face, then choosing the milling icon from the pop-up dialog box. Select profile will automatically pick up all adjacent faces in a loop. Since the profile has now been defined, we will then choose the roughing cutter and add in a contouring operation. We can then control the approach of the tool, whether that be tangent, normal, axial or ramp into the panel itself, but we will choose the normal approach with an overlap and approach distance of 10mm. Leaving the profile Z height as 18mm to match the thickness of the board, with 0mm on the bottom exceeding or lateral thickness, we will then finish this by specifying the maximum depth of passes, which if we state to be 6mm, then SWOOD calculates a total amount of 3 passes. However, this is a bit excessive in this case, so we'll increase the maximum depth to 9mm therefore resulting in only two passes. In the SWOOD CAM feature tree, if we right click and simulate on the profile machining, we are presented with an animation of the toolpath with live updates on X, Y, Z coordinates. Compared to the manual approach, we are now going to utilize SWOOD's machining library, which allows easy and efficient drag and drop applications of saved operations. Inserting an auto pocket into the graphics area picks up the correct geometry via its feature recognition techniques, adding in a pocket milling followed by a finishing walls operation. These operations automatically import the saved tooling. However, if this needs to be altered, we can drag in maybe a finer cutter, such as a 5mm finishing tool, then edit the wall operation within the feature tree, reorder the operation to use the desired tooling. We therefore no longer need the 10mm cutter, so that this can be deleted out of the feature tree. As well as being able to change the tooling, we have full access to modify any of the parameters within the operation, such as reducing the maximum depth of passes to 5mm to result in two step downs. Reorientating the model uncovers two hinge pockets on the bottom face of the panel. This would require the panel to be flipped on the CNC machine. Therefore, we will copy the machining tree in SWOOD to make the modification to the OPO position. After creating a copy, we no longer require the previous contouring and pockets, so these can be removed. Editing the OPO position to a vertex of the model, and most importantly, drive the Z-axis to be normal to the bottom face by picking a vertical edge of the model. To create a manual pocket operation, we will then select all six bottom faces before selecting milling within the command manager. Choose the 5mm finishing as the cutter, then add the pocket milling operation. This technique will allow us to cycle through all profiles, but the parameters set for the toolpath will be global for all of the profiles. The last step is to either run a report to batch export all HTML, CSV and programming files, or select encode just to generate the machining data. I hope that you have found this basic SWOOD CAM overview to be beneficial, but if you are interested for further in-depth training in the product, then please don't hesitate to contact us in regards to this inquiry. Thank you for listening.